Okay, so we are starting with. Data life cycle. In this particular session, very first we'll discuss about the outcome of this session, then introduction of this session, and data lifecycle stages. So very first, the outcome of this session is, after this session, the students will be able to define the data and its importance. Second, the student will be able to define the lifecycle of the data. And third is, the student is able to explain the different stages of the data lifecycle. Now, we move toward the introduction. Very first, data. As you know, any raw fact is called the data. And it is the most valuable asset of any enterprise. Okay? So, the quality data of enterprise is very much useful for that enterprise to generate the useful information as well as to generate the useful knowledge. Okay? And if we talk about the data lifecycle, then it is nothing but a sequence of stages that a particular unit of data goes through from its initial generation or capture to its eventual archival and by all deletion at the end of its useful life. It means now, very first, we are talking about the data lifecycle stages or the components. First stage is data capture. Data capture is itself saying that we are capturing the data from the resources, external resources. Okay. So, very first, data acquisition. Data acquisition is a part of the data capturing. Data acquisition means the ingestion of already existing data that has been produced by an organization outside the enterprise. And data entry is the creation of new data values for the enterprise by human operators or devices that generate data for the enterprise. Third is signal reception, that is the capturing of data created by the devices. Second stage of data lifecycle is data maintenance. The data maintenance is often involves tasks such as movement of the data, integrating the data, the data what we have acquired from different resources, then cleansing the data, removing the noise from the data. We are making it pre-processing task, then enrichment of the data, change data capture, as well as familiar extract, transform, load processes. Mostly data maintenance contains these three phases: extracting the data, transform the data with the help of some pre-processing techniques, and load the data for ready to use. The third phase is data synthesis. In a data lifecycle, data synthesis is also a very important stage, or we can say phase. We can define it as the creation of data values via inductive logic. That means using other data as an input. For example, of inductive logic is net salary, or we can say net sales is equal to gross sales minus taxes, or net salary is equal to gross salary minus tax or other deduction. So we are having two inputs here. We are having two inputs, gross salary, here gross sales and tax. We are applying some mathematical operation, and based on these two data and operation, we are inducting or we are deriving new value, that is net sales. So this is the example of data synthesis. फोर्थ स्टेज ऑफ दी और डेटा लाइफ साइकिल इज डेटा यूसेज. इट कैन बी डिफाइंड एज द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डेटा एज इंफॉर्मेशन टू टास्क दैट द एंटरप्राइज नीड्स टू रन एंड मैनेज इटसेल्फ. दिस इज इन द aspects of using the data for generating the useful information or even generating the useful knowledge, because as we discussed earlier, data is the most valuable asset of any enterprise. Okay, such that if we are having a quality data, then applying appropriate methods or operations to generate the information or to get the knowledge will be helpful to the decision makers of the enterprise. Fifth stage is data publication. Here, which can be defined as the sending of data to a location outside of the enterprise. For example, you most of are familiar with a brokerage that sends monthly statement to its clients. Okay. Or in other way, suppose you are having bank account, then the bank will send the monthly bank statements or your account statement in a PDF form to the client. The sixth stage, or we can say phase of the data lifecycle, is data archival. Data archival is the copying of data to an environment where it is stored in case it is needed again in an active production environment, and the removal of this data from all active production environments. A data archive is simply a place where data is stored but where no maintenance, usage or publication occurs. It means you can understand from this, whatever the data which are not currently in use, which are not transactional data, the data which are now becoming historical data, we are storing this data to the data warehouse or to the data mart, and this data are useful for knowledge generation. They are not useful for online analytical processing. They are the live data are useful for online transaction processing. But whatever the data which are stored in a data archival, they are used for online analytical processing. The last stage of the data lifecycle is data purging. That is the removal of every copy of a data item from the enterprise. Once the data are not required at all, or the data are not longer required, then there is no need of pertaining or no need of keeping the data in the data base. We will remove those particular data from the enterprise database. So this is the last stage.